In the field of neuroscience, an exciting discovery was made. A new type of brain cell was discovered, as if we didn't have enough of those. And it appears to be exclusive to the human brain. So today, on Brief Brain Facts, we're showing our neuronal side. Don't judge. Now that I know I'm in a judgment-free zone, let's talk about our brain cells. Typically, our brain consists of two major cell types, and these cells are known as glial cells, which support, insulate, and provide nourishment to our second cell type, neurons. We have billions of brain cells, but only about 10% of those cells are neurons. There are different neuron types, and a new type of neuron is what has been discovered. Before we get to that new discovery, let's talk a little bit about what a neuron actually is. Neurons are responsible for sensing and communicating change to other neurons in order to bring about a change or response from the body. A neuron consists of a cell body and neurites, the dendrites that receive a signal from a neighboring neuron, and the axon that send a signal to neighboring neurons. Neurons aren't a homogeneous cell type, meaning they aren't all the same. They look and act differently. Most neurons can be classified multiple ways. They are classified based on the neurite, the number of axon and dendrites projecting out of the soma, or cell body. These are the easiest classification, as a neuron can either be unipolar, bipolar, or multipolar. Multipolar neurons are the most plentiful type of neuron. Another way a neuron is classified is based on the appearance of their dendrites. And the appearance of the dendrites are usually associated with certain brain areas. For instance, multipolar neurons throughout most of the cerebral cortex are either stellate cells, which look like stars, or pyramidal cells, which look like triangles or pyramids. Neurons may be classified based on where they are sending or receiving information, i.e. their connections. And most neurons are interneurons, meaning they connect to other neurons. Also, neurons may be classified by the length of their axons. For example, most pyramidal cells have big axon energy because they have long axons. These cells are known as Golgi type 1, or better, projection neurons. These axons are so long, they project from one area of the brain to another. And finally, neurons can be classified based on their chemistry. The neurotransmitter, the chemical messenger, they release. Those chemical messengers may have an excitatory, meaning that it promotes a positive change to the cell membrane potential, or inhibitory, meaning it triggers a negative change to the membrane potential on their postsynaptic targets, their receiving neurons. It's this positive or negative change to the receiving neuron's membrane potential that caused the giving neuron to be classified as either excitatory or inhibitory. In other words, it's all about the friends you keep. Now that we have a basic understanding of the types of neurons and how they're classified, let's turn our attention to the new addition to the family, rosehip neurons. These neurons are classified based on their appearance, as the axons surrounding the cell body, to the researchers, look like a rose without petals. The researchers discovered this neuron type when two separate researchers realized that they found the same thing using completely different techniques. One researcher discovered that the neuron synapses onto the pyramidal neurons located in the prefrontal cortex, while the other researcher discovered the neuron through gene activation, noting that the rosehip neuron activated a set of genes thus far only seen in humans. While the exact purpose of this neuron is unknown, it is considered inhibitory in nature because it inhibits the resting membrane potential of the pyramidal neurons located in the prefrontal cortex, to which it sends information. These rosehip neurons are telling pyramidal neurons to slow their roll. As to why they're doing this, well, scientists don't know yet. However, this is a really exciting discovery, as this cell type appears to be absent in mice brains, and it's currently unknown if other primates also have this cell type. So it does call into question brains modeled off of animals, and how applicable those brains are to human brains. What researchers can surmise is that all properly functioning cells all work towards a common goal: to keep you alive and functioning. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to our channel and make sure to hit that bell so that you receive notifications when we upload new videos. And make sure to hit that like button. As always, thank you for watching.